Friends, we are going to discuss J.M. Synge's play, Riders to the Sea. John Millington Synge was born in Dublin on 16th April 1871 to John Hatch Synge and Kathleen Trail. He had a very short life and died in the year 1909. Synge had graduated from Trinity College, Dublin in 1892, having specialized in Irish and Hebrew. He was a great traveler. In 1893, he spent 1 year in Germany studying music. In 1895, he visited Paris, where he took a course in French literature. In 1896, Synge spent 4 months in Rome and Florence studying Italian languages and art. So you can clearly understand that Synge was somebody who was widely interested in travel. The most important moment in the life of Synge comes when he meets W.B. Yeats in 1896. In this legendary meeting, we have been reported that W.B. Yeats told him, "Give up Paris. You will never create anything by reading Racine. Go to the Aran Islands. Live there as if you were one of the people themselves. Express a life that has never found expression." And on the suggestion of W.B. Yeats, Synge visited Ireland for the first time between 10th May and 25th June 1898. Synge's second visit to Ireland took place in the year 1899 between 12th September to 7th October, which was to be followed by his third visit to Aran Islands on 15th September 1899 and lasted till 3rd October 1899. His fourth visit to Aran Island was also a very significant one. Literary contributions of Synge are significant to place him as one of the most prominent writers of Ireland and Irish literary renaissance. He published In the Shadow of the Glen in 1903. Riders to the Sea, which we are going to discuss, was performed in 1904. The Well of Sense in 1905. The Playboy of the Western World in 1907. The Tinker's Wedding in 1908. Poems and Translations, published in 1909. And of course, Deirdre of the Sorrows, which could not be completed because of Synge's untimely death, was, you know, it appeared in 1910. We must remember here that the lifetime of Synge was a very historically significant period in the history of Ireland. It was also a period of Irish literary renaissance, wherein we see the revival of Irish dramatic tradition. The idea of the Irish theater developed in a conversation between W.B. Yeats and Lady Gregory in 1897. A third important member who contributed later in the founding of Irish National Theatre, also known as Abbey Theatre, was Edward Martin, who was a big landlord and also a Catholic. In 1899, the three literary giants of Irish literary renaissance, Gregory, W.B. Yeats, and Martin, they announced the program of, you can say, Irish National Theatre, and it was decided that a play by W.B. Yeats, The Countess Kathleen, and a play by Martin titled The Heatherfield would be performed in 1899. I must briefly tell you about, you know, Abbey Theatre or Irish Literary Theatre, because it was the most important literary event which stands even today a very important phenomenon. Abbey Theatre was established in 1904. As I told you, it was founded by W.B. Yeats, Isabel Augusta, also known as Lady Gregory. And it was devoted to fostering and promoting Irish drama, to cater to Irish literary needs and promote Irish nationalism. In fact, it was taken over by Irish National Dramatic Society, and later on in 1903, Irish National Theatre Society and Irish Literary Renaissance, they also closely associated with this group. And in fact, by 1904, an English woman whose name was Annie Horniman, who was also a friend of W.B. Yeats, they bought an old theatre in Abbey Street, Dublin, and that place later on was renovated and it was transformed into what we now know as Abbey Theatre. All right? And in fact, Lady Gregory used her social connections to secure support for its theatrical ventures. Martin partially sponsored its economic investments, and W.B. Yeats was its artistic, you know, support, or you can say the man behind the artistic growth and evolution of Abbey Theatre. So, Irish literary drama under the tutelage and leadership of W.B. Yeats was growing rapidly, and one of the most significant playwrights of Ireland who was associated with Abbey Theatre was, of course, J.M. Synge, whose play Riders to the Sea we are going to discuss. The play was written in the summer of 1902. It was first staged on 25th February 1904 by Irish National Theatre Society at Molesworth Hall, Clarendon Street in Dublin. And in fact, Synge himself was its first director. All right? And this play indicated Synge's deep involvement with the people and culture of Ireland, which he has been frequenting on the suggestion and advice of W.B. Yeats. Synge was immersed into the rural life of Aran Island, and he wanted to show that beneath the Irish pagans' Catholicism, there were some pre-Christian pagan beliefs that he wanted to show it to his Irish audience. And also, he reflected, or rather catered to, European desire for an authentic folk culture along with its primitive ism. All right. So, Riders to the Sea was one of the most important literary event. Its performance was greatly appreciated, widely publicized. We'll discuss about the play in our next lecture. Thank you.